let's. You're moving on to puds now.
Yes.
Yes.
This is a super pudding. At least I think it is. There we are. It's a chocolate pudding. Could you get the? I've got one made in the refrigerator.
Put a wrapper on it to keep it nice and clean.
Yes. Free from dust. Now, what it is, Judith? This is one that's been. It looks after itself overnight.
Oh, they're rude, aren't they?
It's layers of chocolate mixture, which is breadcrumbs, chocolate, drinking chocolate powder, and coffee and sugar. And you put layers of that dry mixture with double cream, with single and double cream whipped together. Mm. And you layer it all up, and you do all that the night before. And then it soaks during the night, and it then gets the mixture in the middle becomes nice and sort of cakey. So, first of all, take 4 ounces of breadcrumbs, and these are fresh breadcrumbs made from a new loaf.
And they freeze well, don't they, breadcrumbs?
They do indeed, yes. Mm. So, and add to that 2 level dessert spoonfuls of coffee. That's just ordinary coffee powder.
Mm.
And 4 spoonfuls of drinking chocolate. 2, 3. I'm not quite so heavy-handed as I am with the sherry.
No, I notice.
And then 4 ounces of demerara sugar. It comes in a bit crunchy when it's been. There we are. 4 ounces of demerara sugar. That's the light brown one.
Mm,
and nice and crisply.
And then you stir it all together, obviously, and get them
and
all
blended. And the breadcrumbs. I don't think you would believe that it would be breadcrumbs as soon as they become nice and chocolatey.
I think if you told people you were giving them a breadcrumb pudding, they wouldn't think much to it, would they? But as soon as you say it gets its colour, it looks lovely.
They'd say apple charlotte again, wouldn't they? There we are. Mm. Blend it well. And it's quite easy to know when it's blended enough because you can see that all the bread has been incorporated.
Mm.
So we start off with the dish. This is, you need about a 1.5 pint glass dish. So start off with the crumbs, like that, quite easily. And then I've already whipped the cream, and that is 1/4 single and 1/4 double, whipped together until they're well blended, and then it's fair, not too thick. You can see that isn't too thick, and then put it on like that, and just level it off. And then you see the moisture of the cream goes into the crumbs.
Oh, I see.
And makes it cakey.
So.
There we are. Now, there's no need for me to do any more because you can see how it works. And then you can layer it up right to the top. And then you cover it with a piece of stretchy paper or foil and put it in the fridge as it is now. And then leave it until it's all absorbed overnight.